Hello everyone, I am Gaurav from LogicTuse, and in this video we are going to continue with our PHP GD library next step. Okay, so in this video lecture we are going to add text to the image. In last lecture we discussed how to create a simple image with a blue background here, and we saved it as a project.jpg. okay, and now in this video we are going to add the same some lines of code to add text into this particular image. Okay, fine. So first thing I needed to include in my root folder is the fonts. Yeah, actually when we create the text we need font. We specify the font that PHP uses to build our text. So here's my font in the fonts folder, that is tcceb.tdf. fine. So now I'm going to my index page and I'm creating one more anchor tag to link to another script so that I can get redirected directly to this. Okay, I name it as addText.php, and then okay, like say add text to your image. Fine. Now the next thing I'm going to create is my addText.php. So going to this and then saving it as addText.php. fine. And now into this we are going to create image and then finally going to follow our adding text into it. Okay, so going to some sequential manner right now. Okay, so just go into here, and the next thing we are going to create is creating a variable name output. Okay, let's save this output as my folder of images. Okay, let me maximize the screen for the time. Okay, and I wanted to save my files as images, and under that images text image 1.jpg. fine. Okay, so now next thing I wanted to create is my image variable here, image variable, and that should be image create. Okay, and that will create my image with the variables here, and those are x, that is equals to say 720, and dollar y, that is equals to say 480. Okay, and now let's go and set those parameters into this particular function so that it will define the size of our image, right? Okay, now we are done with our image. The last thing we need to do, image jpeg. We are going to create a jpeg image, and under this you have to write image slash comma and output. Okay, we know by this we can easily by this we simply created the image. Okay, so let's go and test the script first right now. Just refresh this page. Okay, I wanted to do something else, and that is adding a br here so that I can separate the lines. Okay, now I'm just going to this, and this did something. I didn't represented it anywhere. Okay, so what it did, it brought me such a black image here. Okay, so we are going to change the property of this black image and going to change all through it. Okay, so now let's go to text and let's link our image for the display first. So we are going to image, and the source is equal to, I'm going to add PHP line here, and we need an echo, that is dollar output. Okay, fine. So we are here now, and let's test it again, the script. Okay, so this image is now getting shown here. Now let's define some colors. Okay, so let's say colors to use. Fine. So the first color I wanted to define is my white, and that will be image color allocate, and that goes for dollar image comma. We know we have to pass three variables here, And for white is 255, 255, and 255. Okay, and similarly, I'm just going to copy paste this code for two times. Okay, whatever it is. Okay, so now in this part, we are going to change it to black. Black, and that will be my image, and 0, 0, and 0. So let's say right now we are using only two particular colors. Okay, fine. So now what we are doing, we are just going to add one another function that will do all our stuff to adding a text there. Okay, so now let us define a variable here, text1, and that is equals to image ttf text, and under this we need eight parameters to give. Okay, the first parameter is my image that needed to be modified with a text, adding a text. Okay, the second thing we need is the font, is the font size. Okay, so let me give the font size as a 40 pixel, and next thing is the rotation of the font. Okay, so let us give it 0 right now. The next thing is, the next parameter we are going to include is the x value and the y value, the origin of the pixel where the text is going to start. So let us give right now 20 and 40. Okay, so, and the next thing we are going to give is the font color. So we are using a font color of black here. Okay, because we defined the color as black, then we are going to include our font. Now in this case, we are going to use our font right now like this, as we define fonts inside fonts slash pccev dot ttf. Let me check once if the spelling is right, pccev dot ttf. Okay, we are right and cool. And now we are going to include our text here. So let's say logic tubes. Okay. So suppose this particular line of code did all everything for me. So now let's go and test it out. Okay, our image is white right now, and our text is logic tubes. Okay, you can change the value of this to something 80, and this could be something, let's say 120, and then 120. Fine. So okay, what's going on? Yeah, there's a mistake. Yeah, so now we have a white colored image, and the text written there is from black. Okay, now let's go test what is our image here right now is like this. This is how we write image text into an image with the help of PHP GD library. But some other things I wanted to include and share, like I always did in before lectures, that I don't want these values to be like this, okay, or this value to float like this, or change the variable here so that we want it to be independent of changing the functions parameter again and again. So just we are going to include some lines, and then we'll end this lecture up. So for that, first of all, thing I wanted to include is font size, so that it will be more clearer to you that what's going on, and then replace this font size with this. Okay, now dollar rotation. Okay, and you know, this rotation function is this rotation parameter is very cool actually, because I use these sometimes to manipulate text into some directional way, or some handy or random way. So this rotation is very cool. If we assign the rotation 10 here, let's see what happens here. Okay, so by this you can just rotate the text with some axis here about this point, this particular point. Okay, so now let's go and change other values. So let's say origin x is equals to 20, 120, and then origin y is equals to 120. Fine. And let's replace these two with this. Okay, and then this is black as my color I wanted to, and now this is the font. So I'm just copying it right now, and I'm defining it font is equal to control B slash, and then replacing this, and then replacing this with the fonts, and finally adding the text here. And our text is nothing but large case. Okay, so this makes you easy and cool to edit all the things, and you can just change the text over those variables, and then everything is done for you. So LogicQs is a cute website, let's say, and let's test it out. Okay, I'm setting the rotation to 0, and here we go. LogicQs is a cute website. Okay, fine. And once again, if you wanted to change the color of your wall background or so, then what you needed to do as like the same old tutorial, the last tutorial, we have to include in this image, we need to give an image color allocation, and that will be like our old lecture 95, 73 and 255, and that will do all the things for me. Okay, so there's a problem. I expect parameter 1 to be resource and given image, and let's say save it as blue. And is it a clear line? There might be something different over there. Okay, so this did all the things for me. We need to change the variable name here. Okay, fine. So here's the code for adding a text into the image you wanted to. You can just change the color from black to white now, and just go on playing with these kind of stuffs and adding text. And you can even make the application in our further lectures. We are going to make the application of adding random text into your images of or multi-line text and everything about the PHP-GD library. Okay, so that's all for this video. Please subscribe to my channel and do like and share if you like the video, and use the comment section for any doubt or any reviews about it. Thank you.